Hello students, in the earlier class we have studied about different food components present in the food. So for that, in the food it should contain different food components to make it a balanced diet. So there are simple tests here wherein we can test whether the given food item or the food item which we are eating, does they contain different food components or not. So here some of the identification tests, or you can call as confirmation tests for food components. So firstly we are going to see the test for carbohydrates or simply starch. Here is a test for starch or carbohydrates. For this testing the food item for carbohydrates or starch, we need the chemical iodine. Iodine is the chemical where we need for testing the food item for starch or carbohydrate. So iodine, it is in the form of crystals. So firstly we have to prepare the iodine solution. So this iodine solution, we have to take the iodine crystals and adds little bit of water to it, and it can be made into iodine solution. Iodine solution. So this iodine solution, when you observe after preparing, it will be in yellowish brown color. Yellowish brown in color. Iodine solution, it is yellowish brown in color. So for testing the food item for carbohydrates or starch, we have to take a small amount of the food item. To it we have to add the iodine solution, a few drops of iodine solution. So if the food item contains starch or carbohydrate, then the color of the food item, it will change to dark blue in color or black in color. So we can confirm if the food item, when we are adding the iodine solution, it is changing to dark blue or black color, then we can confirm that the taken food item contains starch or carbohydrate is present. We can confirm that the starch or carbohydrate is present. If at all the taken food item does not contain starch or carbohydrate, then there will no change in its color. So iodine solution, it is yellowish brown in color, so the color does not change as the absence of the starch or carbohydrate. If the food item does not contain starch or carbohydrate in it, then there will not be any color change. Then we can confirm that the taken food item does not contain the starch or carbohydrate. In this manner, for testing the carbohydrates or starch, we are going to use the iodine solution. In this manner, we can confirm that the taken or given food item contains the starch or carbohydrates. Next we'll see the test for proteins. So the second test is test for proteins. For testing the proteins, firstly we need two chemicals, that is 2% copper sulfate solution, 2% copper sulfate, and 10% sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. These two are the chemicals required for testing the food items whether they contain proteins or not. So firstly here 2% copper sulfate and 10% sodium hydroxide solutions we have to prepare. Firstly they are in the solid form, that is they are in the form of the crystals. So here how we are going to prepare 2% copper sulfate solution. We'll see. Here 2% means 2 grams of copper sulfate we have to dissolve in 100 ml of water. 100 ml of water. Then it becomes 2% copper sulfate solution. Next, second one, it is 10% sodium hydroxide solution. So here 10% sodium hydroxide means 10 grams of sodium hydroxide we have to take and dissolve in 100 ml of water. 100 ml of water. So for testing the proteins, as we require two solutions, we have to prepare them before going for the test. Now, as the two solutions are ready, now we'll take the food item which we want to test for proteins. So this food item, if it is in the solid form, then add little bit of water to it and make it a solution. So to the food item we have to add 2 drops of copper sulfate and 10 drops of sodium hydroxide solution which we have prepared earlier. Here 2 grams in copper sulfate in 100 ml, so 2% copper sulfate is ready. 10% sodium hydroxide, 10 grams of sodium hydroxide in 100 ml of water. Here also 10% sodium hydroxide solution is ready. So these 2 drops copper sulfate and 10 drops sodium hydroxide solution we have to add to the food item which we are going to test for proteins. Now we check. Now, so if at all the food item which we are testing over here, after the addition of the two solutions, if it is changing into violet color or purple color, the solution is changing into violet or purple color, then this food item which we are taken, it contains proteins. So here we can confirm that proteins are present. Proteins are present in it. Proteins are present. If there is no color change, that means, as we know that copper sulfate, it is light blue in color, it remains as it is, there is no color change, then we can say that the food item which we have taken does not contain proteins. When there is a color change like violet or purple, then we can say that proteins are present in the food item which we have taken. So this way we can test for proteins. So you have to remember these two chemicals, 2% copper sulfate and 10% sodium hydroxide are required for testing for test for proteins. Next test is test for fats. Test for fats. So how we are going to test for fats? So whatever the food item which we are going to test, we have to take that food item and rub it on a paper. Rub it on a paper. So if the food item we are taking and rubbing it on a paper, if the paper changes to translucent, if the paper becomes translucent, translucent means oily. If the paper is become oily, that is translucent, then we can confirm that the food item which we have taken contains fats. That means fats are present. Fats are present. If the paper is changing into translucent or oily, then we can confirm that the food item taken contains fats. So fats are present. So in this manner, we can test 3 different food components. First one, carbohydrates or starch, we need iodine solution. And for testing the proteins, we need copper sulfate and sodium hydroxide. And here test for fats, the paper is changing into translucent. So in this manner, we can confirm that the given food item, whether it contains carbohydrates or starch and proteins and
fats. So this is the way we do identification test. Okay children, thank you and keep watching for more videos, and do please like, share and subscribe. Thank you children.